Dunedin streets have a bold new look. 10 walls around the city have been transformed as part of the inaugural Street Art Festival. Now the event's wrapping up, and organisers are hailing the artwork as a win for the city.
We kind of took a bit of a chance. We weren't sure whether people would be that into it. We'd had a few roll out a couple of months ago and last year, and they went really well. But people have just been saying, hey, this is really great, want to see more of this around town.
Hazelton's been amazed by the public response to the festival, and says some locals are even suggesting possible sites for new artwork. He believes there's a myriad of benefits to holding the event, including proving to local kids that art can be a career.
For us, it's about making the city more vibrant and making it a more exciting place, and particularly introducing some colour. You know, most of the locations we've chosen are places where there used to be buildings once upon a time and now there's not, but getting people to look at those places again, you know, is great.
9 artists have been slaving over their works for the past week and a half. With the festival in its last few days, many of the murals are done, and locals are free to admire the view. Hazelton says fingers are crossed for one more mural going up, which should be confirmed in the coming days. With that in mind, festival conveners are thinking about the event's future in the city.
We're all pretty tired after the last couple of weeks, and you know, we've been joking that I would never do it again, but I think we'll forget that pretty quickly, and I think there will be a 2015 event. We've still got lots of artists that we want to get to New Zealand. There's lots of local artists that we really want to showcase as well.
Hazelton is inviting local artists keen to make their mark on the city streets to get in touch, so neglected space can be made a bit more beautiful in a future festival. David DeLorean, 39, Dunedin News.